Women in the Quran are important characters and subjects of discussion in the stories and morals taught in Islam. Some of the women in the Quran are portrayed in a positive light while others are condemned for their actions. Maryam is the only woman mentioned in the Quran by name. The others' names come from other traditions. Most of the women in the Quran are represented as either the mothers or wives of certain leaders and prophets. Women in the Quran retained an amount of autonomy from men in some respects. For example, the Quran describes women who converted to Islam before their husbands did, or women who took an independent oath of allegiance to Muhammad. Eve, like all other women in the Quran, save for Mary, is not mentioned by name. However, in later hadith, she is referred to as Hawa. She appears in a total of three surahs, referred to both as Adam's partner and wife, while Adam appears separately in an additional two. The Quranic narrative of Adam and Eve's creation, in the Quran Hawa's role is minimal, as she is the accomplice to human sin rather than the instigator. It is Adam who is forewarned by Allah that Iblis, Satan, is his and Hawa's natural enemy, and the threat to getting them removed from heaven. So we said, O Adam, this is an enemy to you and to your wife, therefore let him not drive you both forth from the garden so that you should be unhappy. Quran, Surah 20, Taha, Ayat 117. The literal Quranic text in many ways removes the blame that is often placed upon Eve. Instead of being portrayed as the cause of Adam's fall, Eve is merely presented as equally compliant in the sin and then later, equally compliant in the punishment and atonement. However, the early exegesis surrounding the creation, and therefore, the early medieval exegesis focus on depicting Hawa as morally and mentally compromised. Hawa is seen as the one who tempts the prophet Adam into sin. In particular, the early work of hadith-based scholar Al-Tabari showcases many passages that claim women's menstruation and the affliction of bearing children are a direct result of Hawa's foolishness. Were it not for the calamity that afflicted Hawa, the women of this world would not menstruate, would be wise, and would bear their children with ease. Al-Tabari, I-529. However, in modern times the exegesis and general understanding of Hawa have shifted, and are deeply debated. Her status as the first woman in the world is incredibly relevant since she is looked upon as the model for her sex and Allah's archetype of a woman. Today both traditional and modernist thinkers look to Hawa either to support or deny their argument regarding the equality of women in the religion. Specifically, those with a traditionalist view believe in the hadith and exegesis that Hawa was created from one of Adam's crooked ribs. And therefore when the prophet explained women were created from the crooked part of the rib, he was not blaming the woman, but was defining women's natural disposition and the preponderance of emotions over rationality. In response, more liberal interpretations cite no direct and incontestable truth that Hawa was created from a crooked rib. They claim such suggestions do not stem from verifiable sources. Rather, they strive to emphasize the purpose of the creation and fall story itself, which was not to decry the human nature of either sex, but act as an example of Allah's guidance, punishment, and ultimate forgiveness.